Hello guys, so welcome to another video. So as promised, like we have been updating the Fawzathon challenge almost every week, so I thought we'll do it again for this week, because for this week I think it's pretty easy. So first up, you have to own and drive the 2013 Ford Shelby GT500. That is a very easy thing to do. Then you have to win 3 drag strip events, any drag strip events, it doesn't matter which ones. And after that, you have to stack a total of 1 million skill score in your Ford Mustang. That should be easy to do as well. We'll just take the car to the highway. We'll put we'll use some skill points in the skill section of the car, the car mastery section actually. And then we just have to win a road racing series at the Lake of Forest Sprint. That's it. So I think the thing which will take the Welcome most back, time Captain. Will be to earn the 1 million skill points, but that shouldn't be that hard to do. A couple of runs on the highway and we should be done. So I'm going to just change the car. I'm going to go to Ford and the GT500 is here. So I have two of these. So one is tuned to S1 class and one is tuned to A class. I'll take the one with the S1 class. Both of them, they are tuned by me. So let me know if you guys want me to upload the tune, and I'll upload the tune. So the first thing is that we have to win some drag races, right? Okay. So we'll start with this, because I think this is the basic level of drag strip which everyone must do. Let's go here, click on solo, Horizon Presents, Shelby GT500. Shouldn't take us that much time at all. So we are into the festival drag strip. Let's start it up. We have a Dodge Charger with us, the Dodge Challenger actually, the Hellcat, but we are winning so easily, and this is not even a drag build. . 9.6 seconds, that's not too bad for an S1 class car while shifting using the automatic shifting. Let's go and do another one, but a different one. We can do the one here or here. I think we'll do the one here. This is the beach one. So it's a little bit tricky because you are driving on sand, but I think our car should do just fine. Look at how, like, this car is beached for sure. Anyway, so where's the event? I don't know why we did not fast travel exactly there, but we're just going to drive there. Enter event, solo. Yep. So guys, these events are pretty easy to do, and I think the difficulty settings is expert as well, so it's very easy to do these events. I think the one thing which is going to take a little bit of time, that is the 1 million score. That's it. We are winning easily, like it's, we cannot even see the other people. 18.4. Yeah, the design is from the movie Need for Speed, so yeah, it looks definitely, it looks good on this one. Also, before I go any further, okay, nothing too special here. But before I go any further, I would, what is this? I haven't seen this before. Ah, okay, cool. We'll come back to that later, offline maybe. So we should upgrade this. This is going to help us a lot. The wheel spins are not going to help us, so we are not going to touch those. No, this is not going to help as well, so I think this is fine. And the last one, I think we'll do this one, the Juggernaut. So I think this is the longest track strip in the game, and it's pretty interesting as well, because for this one there are some high speed corners. So if you build a car which is just for top speed, or maybe it's like just for straight line acceleration and it doesn't have any cornering, then you have to watch out in those corners. But for now, since this is not a proper drag belt, this car should be good enough for those tracks. And you also have to take care of the like the top speed of the car, because on this track strip the car is going to hit the top speed for sure. So we are doing pretty good, nobody else is even close to us. Let's see the top speed for this car actually. So it's at 205, 210. miles per hour almost. That is pretty good for an S1 class car. And we crossed the line at 211 miles per hour. And that took us only 52 seconds. That's not bad. And we did not even face any difficulty in those high speed corners. Okay, so this is done. And we also did, I think, this challenge. So this is done. I thought we did one of the daily challenges, which is to earn two great near miss kills. That will be very easy to do once you get on the highway. Closely overtake while racing to earn three awesome pass kills. That will be also really easy to do once you do the race, so not too worried about that. Now we get to this 1 million skill score. Okay, so we are already on the highway, so we're just going to continue on this. And let's see what skill score we can stack. So that was pretty bad, just 100. But that's okay. A near miss, great speed, hard charger. We have to make sure that we do not hit anything. That's the first daily challenge done. But yeah, I was saying that we have to make sure that we do not hit anything. Because then we are going to lose all the skill score. So that is not bad. I just hope that we do not bank. Oh, we banked. There is no skill chain for like awesome speed or anything like that. Like just for the speed skill, like there's no skill point in the car mastery which can help us gain additional skill points when it comes to speed for this car. I don't know why that is, but it's still good enough. I mean, yeah, it's going to take some time to get to that. Like, it's going to take some time in order to get those 1 million skill points. And we crashed it. So that skill score goes down the drain. That was around 14,000. So we lose that. So you guys do have to watch out for that for sure. It's better to just brake. when in situation like this and not just crash into the traffic, because that is going to make you lose the entire skill score. I decided to drift there, but yeah. About 7,000 again. Almost 9,000 now. If you're doing a good speed, it usually doesn't cash out like that. But I'm glad it did, otherwise we would have lost everything. I'm just trying to maintain this drift. The skill score. Oh no, what did I do? Okay, let's go back onto the highway. I think I'm just going to do the highway run one or two times more, that's it. Because it gets pretty boring after some time. But what I really want to do is maybe do a couple of races with it. We'll try not to hit anyone and we'll still be getting the skill section, like the skill points. We lose everything again. Okay, let's just do a race. We have a message as well. That's just a daily payout. And we have a wheel spin. Okay, before I go into the race, I just want to compare my tune with the tune made by other people. So we have 1000 horsepower and we weigh 3800 pounds. This one, I think it's a drag build maybe, because it says 0.0 to 60 in 1.3 seconds. So yeah, I'm guessing it's a drag build. I think this build, it's really good, but this is rear wheel drive. So I will not be going for that. This build is good actually when it comes to power to weight ratio. Not sure about the handling and the braking. I think my handling and braking are only better because of the weight, but otherwise I think this tune is better than me. Yep, that tune, this is pretty good actually. This is pretty good. Not this one, but this one, yes, definitely. Unknown UPC, you guys can try this tune. Oh yeah, we were about to do an event, so you know what, we'll go a road racing event, maybe this one. Let's see if that can help us. We'll just see how much time we spend on this event and how much skill score we get, but we have to make sure that we do not hit any walls or any other cars, because you have to watch out for the cars of the opponent as well. So that is a really crucial thing. If this doesn't work out that well, I think we'll go back to the highway and try to do it. I think this is the only tiresome part of this Forzathon weekly challenge, but you guys, it just depends. If you know, if you need those 100 Forzathon points, then yeah, I think you should definitely do it. Okay, that guy was hitting me, like, but that's okay. That's not too bad actually, 9000 skill points. I think the trick is just like not to lose them. I don't even care about coming first. So that's 32,000 for us. I'm just trying to drift through these corners, because that is going to help us with the points. And let's just wreck these small things in the way. Ultimate clean racing, that's pretty good. Another 9,000 for us. Show off ultimate drift. There's something wrong with the AI. Okay, I should probably stop doing this because sometimes these things, they don't work out. Oh shit, I lost it again. That was a really good score which I lost. I probably should not have done that. I should have probably slowed down. I know it says every red dragon on the car in front, but that is actually not, that is just the AI, because as you guys know that AI sometimes they use the game attacks of real people, especially your friends. Okay, this race was completely useless. Completely useless race because we crashed on the highway. So yeah, nothing too special going on here. Let's just see how much we are already done. I think it should not be more than 10%. Autumn 80% complete. That's pretty good. Crown Victoria unlocked. That's great. I don't think I had the ground break, so that's pretty good. So yeah, we're just 10% over there. We have 90% to do. So I think the rest of the video is going to be pretty boring. You guys, if you want it, you can just skip it down. Skip this thing. But yeah, I have to stay here and I have to get those 1 million for you guys. To be honest, I don't need it, but I think in the last Forzathon shop there was an Apollo Intensia and it was for, if I'm right in saying, it was for 2000 Forzathon points, and I thought it will not exceed 1000 Forzathon points for sure, but since it is one of the rarest cars in the game, it did, and it was for 2000 Forzathon points. And I only had like 1400, although I have that car, so I did not need to buy it, so that is okay. But for you guys who don't have that car and who missed out on that car, it is one of the best handling cars when it comes to S2 class. I have personally like not driven it that much, but I have seen many people saying that the handling is one of the best. Maybe we'll try it in a future video, maybe, who knows. So it is at its max top speed, which is 223. Okay, we just missed the traffic. I think we need to slow down. The drift slowed down a lot. What was that? Seriously? We lost everything in that. Okay, I have to get that back. I have to get the skill score back. Awesome speed. If it goes to 200, we start getting ultimate speed. So that's pretty good. Okay, we came off the highway. We have to get back on it. Even though one of the best things to do is also do this. This is also a good way to earn a lot of skill points really fast. the wreckage helps a lot. You get these things called landscaping, side swipe. That really helps. See, we got sky side swipe, great skill chain, wrecking ball, awesome skill chain, and we're not even driving that fast. Ultimate wreckage. That's like 45,000 almost there. Guys, I have to admit, I'm really bad at this, at getting the skill scores. So that was 50,000. That's pretty good. Good. Another run at the highway. Let's see what we do. I think if we can just keep the skill score, then maybe we can do well. Even the skill multiplier, it's not building that fast. I think the highest it went to was 3. Really, I hate the traffic in this game, but that is what it's helping us getting those near miss skills. Let's just try doing this. Yeah, see, this doesn't help. It's just at 2.2. 2.4. 2.5. This needs to go till 5 in order for us to do well. So this is a good score. This is around 66,000. That's not bad. I think this is the highest which we have ever banked in this session. And I think that's pretty good. That one, that was another 6,000. So going for another run. Ultimate speed. Again, ultimate speed. The game lagged, so I thought I should break because I really don't want to mess up my skill score again, because this is already 35,000. Okay, we banked, but that's okay. We need like a good skill score going. Now we're going quite fast, and the skill score is also building really fast. I don't know why the game starts to lag. There's something wrong with my system maybe, or maybe there's something wrong with the updates which the game has been receiving. I really hope it's the game and it's not the system, because I just got this Xbox. So before this I was playing on my PC, but yeah, I decided to go for an Xbox One X. Frankly, both are pretty similar, but the Xbox, it can record the videos really well. So yeah, that is what gave it the edge. Like awesome speed. I hope we don't break the skill chain. We banked. That is almost as worse. That's okay. That built up like really quickly. I thought we'll go this way. We'll try to see if we can get more skills on this road. Since we're at the speed zone, the guys should be they're transparent. I can do a little bit of a wreckage. Even these small ones, they will count. Now we have to be careful because the traffic is not going to be transparent. That's like we are at the max skills. The multiplier is at max, so we need to make sure we get this banked. And we are at 36,000 multiplied by 5, that is 180,000. So I think that is like the best for the day. I know I'm not driving that good because I'm constantly looking at the skill score, but don't blame me for that. It's going to be quite good, I think. We are at 55,000. Game has started to lag a lot, so I think I'm just going to play it safe, and I'm just going to let it bank actually, because the game is lagging a lot. Yeah, so let's just bank it. We're at 67,000 actually. That's 336,000. That's pretty good, and that should help us quite a bit. So we are at 67% actually. We are like 2/3 there. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll go back on the highway and we'll try to see how that goes for us. But this was extremely helpful. Like another one like this, and we are just done. We are sorted. We just like need like 333,000. Yep, that's it. So not too much. But let's see if we can do it. So we got the skill score going now. Trying to do some wreckage in order to boost the skills. I don't know which way I came, but I'm just going to keep driving down this road to see if we can get a good skill score going. I think places like this is also not a bad idea, because there's a lot of trees where you can hit stuff and you can get the wreckage points. I think this was definitely not the street from where we came. Okay, it's time to take a U-turn. So that was 55,000, so that's pretty good, I think. I'm just going to wreck everything. Okay, that also ended our skills in C. Sometimes that happens, so we have to be careful about that. These are like 10,000 points easy. Getting a lot of score by wrecking stuff actually. And this is a drift zone, so the car will be transparent. We can actually drift in peace and get the drift score going as well. Okay, that did not went as good as I was hoping, but that's okay. 113,000, that's okay. I'm glad I let it bank there, because who knows, maybe the car would have hit the road really hard when we were coming off the wall, so that's pretty good. Should we go into the city? I think we should definitely try it. Okay guys, we're going into the city. Let's see if it helps us. So there are not a lot of objects except these actually. These are pretty helpful. But see, there's some objects in the city in which you don't know if you can hit it or not. I'm just going to set the waypoint for over here. How much are we done? 851, so we are like really close. We just need another 150,000 and we will be done with this.
In 100 yards, turn left. In 400 yards.
Oh, there's a train. We barely missed that. That's like about 25,000 there.
At the roundabout, take the first exit. You have arrived at your destination.
So Even if we bank, that's fine. That's 43,000. We just need another 100,000 or so and we'll be done with this. We'll try to get a good skill score going, like the skill chain going over here, because there's a lot of traffic on the road, so we just need to dodge them and destroy some of these maybe. But that banked in like too early. See, the game is starting to lag again. I don't know why that is. I really don't know why today the game is lagging so much. Usually it never does. And you know, just today I was admiring this Xbox that it can record the videos and all really well. So we got another 28,000, so like another 75,000 or something to go. That was a good jump. We instantly got like 7,000 from it. Threading the needle. Okay, let's drift in and see what happens. No, don't crash. I don't know how we survived that, but I think we are going to be done by the time this skill chain ends. I'm just going to stand over there. 116,000, Gymkhana completed. Great. So now we just have to go and win a road racing series event. That's it. Okay. So we'll go to world map. Road racing is on, so Lake Halfor Sprint is somewhere over here. Yeah, this one. We just have to win this and we are done. So the hardest part of the challenge is done. This should take another like 3 or 4 minute stops. So let's just get started. Solo, Lakehurst, Shelby GT500, of course. This is the last bit of the challenge, and this challenge I think it will take around 40 to 45 minutes to complete. If you guys are better at drifting and like maintaining the skill score, then you might even do it sooner. Yeah, but if you guys suck then like me, then yeah, of course it can take a lot of time to complete. So winning here means getting on the first place, and we are. And as you guys can see, like this, it's a pretty good car. Yeah, it is definitely quite heavy, and I wish it was lighter. Maybe the other tune will be good compared to this, but it actually depends, you know, on if it has the aero and the splitter and everything going on. Because if it does, then yeah, then I see no reason to choose that tune, because some of the tunes over there, they might have better power, they might be lighter, but you don't know if they have the right tires, if they have the right aero, and you definitely do not know how they are going to perform in the races. So that is the reason why I'm usually like, if I have time, I just tune the car myself. Because at least I know what the car is capable of and what it is designed to do. Like here, yeah, we have the race tires with us. And yeah, of course, if you can remove the race tires and maybe go for weight reduction, yeah, maybe your car can be a little bit lighter as well. We'll check that after this race, you know. I mean, like maybe if we go with like sport tires or street tires, like can our car be lighter? Because that was a lot of weight, like difference in weight, that was around like 700 pounds. And that's a lot. That is like 20% of this weight. So yeah, we'll definitely give it that a go after this phase. Because right now I don't think I've done the weight reduction on this car. I just wanted to give it a lot of power, which I did, and it's pretty good. So the upcoming section is the speed section actually on this track, and on that section it depends if your car is good in the high speed corners and if it has a good top speed or not. That's the OP line. So let's see if this car is good in the high speed corners. We already know that it has a good top speed. But can we go through this whole section without braking and keeping our foot down? Almost. We had to just tap the brakes a little bit, but that's okay. That's okay. That's first place for us. And I think this concludes it. This concludes the challenge. Snake Charmer completed. We get the Fawzathon points. Now we are at 1500. The Fawzathon shop for this week, it's not too special. You can get the Auto Union Type D. If you guys remember in the last video, we were talking about which car this is when we were racing the Bugatti 35 T35 and the Alfa Romeo P3. So yeah, so it was not the Mercedes-Benz. This was the Auto Union Type D. Yep, this was the car which looked the best. This is already B class, so yeah, maybe you guys can tune it and make it for A class. But yeah, this car was nice. And this is the Volkswagen bus, like the Volkswagen van. I don't know why it's for 650 credits, because this thing doesn't even matter like who uses it anyway. But the rest of the stuff is pretty standard stuff. And I think I'm just going to save my 1500 Fawzathon points unless something really cool comes in the Fawzathon shop. So guys, I'll wait for this video, but before I do that, as promised, I want to go to the festival and I want to see if maybe I can change the tires and put weight reduction on it so that the tune will be better. Upgrades and tuning, custom upgrade. So you know what, we'll first apply the weight reduction. The weight reduction is over here. That is it. This was the thing which was left out. Okay, so everything else I'm not going to touch. I'm just going to touch the tires because I know that makes a lot of difference. So you can see if you use the stock tires, which is the street tires, I think the car is actually going to be lighter. And you know what, I'm just going to compare it. I'm just going to compare the starts this time. I'm clicking on search but nothing is happening. Maybe I'll try it again. Yep, I think it's broken. Yeah, it just took some time. Yeah, this was the tune. So this one, no, I think this was not the tune. Where did that tune go? Yep, this was the tune. So if you guys no, this was also not the tune. Oh god, where did the tune go? Yep, this is a drag build. I remember it was showing that it was by this guy, but now it doesn't have the same weight. Interesting. Anyway, guys, if you see like our tune, yeah, if you compare it with this one, this is a drift tune. And look at the start, it's a rear-wheel drive car. What else? Yeah, everything else, it doesn't have nearly to as much power to weight ratio as we do. unless it's a track car for sure. Everything else is for track. This one, I'm not sure what this car is. This is a rear-wheel drive car, but so that doesn't matter. Yep, I think this is it. Everything which is faster than us is rear-wheel drive, but we are so much lighter. Even if I upgrade the flywheel to the fullest, we are still producing like so much power. We can make it like 1041 horsepower, but you know what, I'm not going to do that. And the flywheel, yes, we are going to upgrade that. That is done. And this car is pretty good. I just wish we can upgrade the tires a little bit. I know it doesn't have to be race tires, at least the sport tires should do. And the weight, we are just going to increase it a little bit. I know I want it to be light, but we need good tires as well. The stock tires are definitely not the best. So the weight reduction, we're just going to tone it down a little bit. That's 3500 pounds. That's pretty good now. I think this is a good compromise. If you go with this, this reduces 1300 and then 772. This is this just removes almost everything, I think. Okay, if we go with this, then can we put on race tires? No, we cannot. Oh, that sucks. That sucks. We can also make this car for rallying if you guys are into that. But yeah, I don't think the race tires are that important. Yeah, they definitely increase the start a lot. They put our acceleration at 10, they put increase our braking, they increase our handling, but end of the day the lightness also matters. We can do this. We can do this as well, because we haven't done that. We can make them stick out. They are already all the way out. What else? It has the aero, it has everything going on. I don't think there's anything left on this car. I'll just give it a go and check it out once more. It has pretty much all the upgrades a car could have. You are right, it says fully maxed out. It's still at S1897. Still at S1897. So I guess this is a pretty good build. This is a pretty good build. I wish we could have gotten with race tires, but of course we cannot. But I think this is a good compromise. I've still somewhere down the line I want to go with the weight reduction, like the full weight reduction, because I still think when I'm driving this car it's too heavy. Maybe we can come up with a better power to weight ratio. Maybe we can drop the power for the turbos. I really want to keep it at that 1000 horsepower, you know. Okay, you know what, I think I'm just going to go crazy with it. If I have to make it lighter, I have to drop down the power, and I think the best way to do that is to remove the things which affect the top speed of the car actually. I think this is going to be it. We are reducing 126 horsepower from this, And we can add this. This was actually decreasing up here, you know. And even this, it increases the weight a little bit, just a tiny bit, but increases, at least it makes it 900 horsepower. So that's pretty good in my opinion. The flywheel, we're going to stick with the normal one. Ooh, it's so crazy. Like, it just takes so much time when we are building these sort of cars. This car is better at speed, handling and acceleration, but the braking is not too good. But if you look at the power to weight ratio, I think ours is slightly better. Ours is a lot better. I think I need to get the calculator out, but I think ours is a lot better than this one. You know what, I think I'm just going to keep it like this. Install the setup. Yeah, of course. Since we have changed the tires, I think I need to change the tire pressure and all again. So I'll go into tuning. I'm just going to make it 20 psi. I think they should be fine. The gearing is fine because I did not touch the gears. I did not touch anything else actually. So I think everything else, it should be good. The current setup has been applied. I think I can make the gears a little bit longer. So right now it's at 1.74, 3.96 and 216, 218, 219.2, just a little bit more, 219.7, just give me 220, 220.1, yep. This is the gear ratio which we are going to use. A quick test drive to see if our car is good or not. This feels so much better, like it accelerates so much quicker. It's so much more agile thanks to losing all that weight, you know. But yeah, see, the cornering ability has been affected. We'll just try that again. Cornering is actually not too bad as well. And yeah, the race tires would have been much better for sure, there's no doubt about that. But I think this car, it still goes quite quick. And off-road, it's able to handle quite well. You know what, the best way to try this thing is, I know we don't have a lot of time, but I'm just going to do the Jaggernaut again. So I think last time I finished around 52.2 seconds. So is this faster? Is this faster? I think this should be faster. But because the top speed is increased by a little bit, I know it doesn't make that much of a difference, but yeah, on a track like this it might. The tires are not that good, so the acceleration is definitely affected, but the weight is so much less, so I think it should be quicker. We're just quickly going to do this race, and maybe we'll do the festival race as well, because that was 9.6 seconds, so I want to see if we can do better than that. This was 52.2, so that is our aim to beat. Come on, Shelby. I know you can do it. Okay, I did not brake for that one. I just turned the wheel as much as I can. It's going to be it's definitely going to be close. Is it going to make it? It's pretty close. 52 dead. Just 0.2 seconds of a difference, but yeah, I'll take it. We are going to the festival race as well. I don't remember the time for the beach one, otherwise I would have definitely attempted that one as well, but I think two drag races should be enough. Okay, let's go. I think this was okay in 9.6 seconds. 9.6. So yeah, on this road it did not really matter, but on that one, yeah, I think it made slight difference. But I think the difference where you're going to see is in the corners, because it is so much lighter, so it can control its weight, and it looks so good. It looks so good. I just love this Mustang. Anyway guys, that'll be it for this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Cheers!